In this video, I'll go through the steps to create a custom video component that will autoplay when in view and offer a landscape or portrait version of the video. So in this example project, I've got a skeleton or wireframe for a page built out. The video section is further down over here. And I have a placeholder where I'll insert my video. So to do that, I'm simply going to go insert, go to media. So I'm going to use the video component. However, you could also use the YouTube or Vimeo component. So I'll just simply drag that there and place that inside this section. I'm going to delete the placeholder, and then I'm going to lock this aspect ratio and set it to full or relative. So now that fills the container, and the container has a max width of 960 pixels. Next, I'm going to frame this component. Use the keyboard shortcut, and then I'll name this frame video player. So now I can see that the video player is positioned absolutely with a width of 100%, and then I'm going to also lock the aspect ratio of that, and now it's fully responsive across all the three breakpoints. I can also set a border radius and set the overflow to clip or hidden. So I'm going to give it a border radius, and this is totally optional. And then with this selected, I'm going to turn this into a component. So to turn this layer component, I can use a keyboard shortcut, Command Option K, or just create component. I'll keep the name video player. And now I have my component created. I'm going to name this primary variant. I'm going to lock this keyboard shortcut, Command L. Just lock that. Then I'm going to drag an overlay frame to create my overlay. So I'm just going to use layout and drag that over there, and that creates an overlay. I'll give it a color. I'm going to make it black, set it all the way to black, and then I'm going to just adjust the opacity here. And I'll make sure it's positioned absolutely, and then I'm going to name it, and also ensure it has a Z index, and I'll set it to 1. Next, I'm going to lock this as well. So use the shortcut key, Command L, lock that. Then I'm going to go to assets, and I'm going to add an icon set to this, which will be my play button. So switch to assets. I already have this play button created. I'll just drag it to the center about there, and then I'm going to set the Z index for the button to 2, and I'll leave it at that, and then I'll also just lock this. Right, so that's the paused component setup. Now I just need to ensure that my settings are correct for this video. So I'll go to select the video, go to the properties panel. So I want to make sure the properties for this video component has muted set to yes, controlled set to hide. And then I'm going to upload the video, and also make sure the playing is set to no for the paused state. And I'm not going to use a hosted, self-hosted URL. I'm going to upload directly. When uploading videos, there are certain limitations. It's recommended to keep videos under 20 megabytes. As Framer does not optimize video playback for the web, and you can use tools like Handbrake to compress the videos and also ensure that the codec is an H.264 codec and MP4 file extension, as these are most widely supported. And then with the video uploaded, I'm also going to ensure I have poster set to yes, and I'm going to upload my poster image, as this is also recommended. Right, so next I'm going to duplicate this to create the playing variant. So I'll select the primary variant and I'll go Command D or duplicate, Control D on Windows. And then with the playing component selected, I'm going to select the play button and the overlay and set the opacity to 0. Select the video, and then I'm going to set playing to yes. Now I've noticed that the positioning, I need to adjust the positioning of this. So let me just undo the aspect ratio, and that should fix the positioning. Right, so now it's positioned perfectly. And now I'm going to exit the component. And before I exit, I also just want to ensure that muted is set to no for the playing component. Right, so that should be set up. So now I'm going to exit the component editor. And I can see that I need to once again set the aspect ratio. And then now if I preview that, I can see nothing really happens. So I'm going to apply the scroll effect. So with the video player component selected, go effects, scroll variant. I'll leave trigger as laying in view. You can also set section in view if you have a section. Scroll section set. I'll leave this as middle, yes, and then I'll say paused and then to playing. And then I'll preview that. I'm going to create a phone variant of this component. So I'll just once again head back into the component. So I'm going to duplicate this, but I'll first rename this one. So I'll rename the landscape or wide version of the video. And then I'm going to duplicate that. And I'll rename this one. So for this version, the portrait version, I'm going to swap the width and the height. I'm going to unlock the aspect ratio, give it a fixed width, and then I'm going to swap the values around. And then I'm going to once again lock the aspect ratio and then set it to relative and 100%. And with this landscape version selected, I'm going to upload the portrait or vertical version of the video. and upload the poster for that video. Then I'm going to hide this for the primary, and then I'm going to duplicate this variant and I'm going to name it. Then I'll hide the landscape version and show the portrait version, and then I'm going to unlock the aspect ratio, set this to, swap the values here as well, and then I'm going to lock that. And if I see my video, I can see it. That's correct. So that's correct. And now I just need to make sure that this is all correct. So control set to hide, muted yes, and playing set to no. I'm going to duplicate this variant, name it phone playing, select the play and the overlay, set that to zero opacity, select the video component, and then set that playing to yes, and muted is set to no. I'll exit the component editor, and then on the phone variant, which I've selected here, I can select it again. I'll set the variant to phone paused, and then I'm also going to change the scroll effect and change the variants from phone paused to phone playing, and then I'll preview that. So having video autoplay when only in view is a good practice, as will not consume unnecessary resources when not in view. However, unoptimized videos may have playback issues in some browsers, and using a streaming service would be recommended if having issues uploading video. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and take care till next time.